What is up, YouTube? Welcome back to another part of my Tales of Berseria gameplay. So, we just finished conquering Titania, and now we're off to find an Earth Pulse.
The first mate told me we're going to be looking for an Earth Pulse thingy, right? The ship's ready to leave whenever. Do you want to depart now?
It's here! This is the Earth Pulse Point!
Nothing but open water as far as the eye can see. Is your Earth Pulse Point down below?
Most of this world is covered by ocean, so of course there'd be a lot of Earth Pulse Points in the deep sea.
But surely even the Abbey would have a hard time containing a Therion underwater, right?
Looks like this one's a bust then.
Sorry, everyone.
Hold on. We've seen a bug Therion. You don't think there could be fish as well?
You may have a point. I think I have just a solution for this.
You do?
This.
What?
Don't give me that look. I'll have you know this is Fujibayashi's rod. This baby's 9 feet long, made from a single piece of the finest bamboo aged 5 years, with a slow 60-40 action that almost feels alive when it bends. Its exquisitely wrapped handle feels like an extension of your own arm. And just look at that elegant black lacquer finish. It's as perfect a fishing rod as there can be.
I'm sure it's a lovely fishing pole, but fishing? Are you sure? This is a Therion we're talking about.
All the more reason. Remember who you travel with.
Okay.
All right, if no one else will, I'm going to veto this fishing idea.
Aw, come on, let's give it a shot. Besides, I'm hungry. Even if all we catch is fish, at least we'll have dinner.
I'd love to have me some koi or sockeye salmon.
Don't encourage them. How do you attach the hook to the line? Like this?
You don't go fishing much, do you?
It's just been a while. I used to go fishing with my brother sometimes.
This is my first time.
Then we can try it together.
I'll teach you how it's done.
I didn't know you could fish, Eleanor.
Yeah, when I was little, old man Tenny taught me. He was from my village. I've caught at least 100 triet loaches over the years.
Wow, that's a lot of fish.
Those two really get along. If I didn't know better, I think she's his sister, not his vessel.
Eleanor certainly got Lafayette's number. Better watch out, Velvet, or she'll steal him away.
Lafayette.
Let's get the line set up properly. First, you take it and thread it through the hook, like so.
That looks hard.
Hey.
Once you get the hang of it, you'll be able to do it with your eyes shut.
Okay, I'll give it a shot.
Luffy!
Huh? You mean me?
Oh, I was just... Be careful there. Wouldn't want you falling into the water or anything.
I'm not a little kid, you know.
It's just that Luffy fell in once. A long time ago.
Luffy? You mean your younger brother?
That's right. You reminded me of him is all.
If you say so. Is that all you wanted to say to me?
Yeah, that's it.
Okay then. I'm going back to fishing with Eleanor.
Mm-mm. People aren't as easily swapped in and out as fish hooks, are they?
Is that supposed to mean something?
Oh, Velvet! You gotta get it a lot tighter than that. Here, let me take a look at it.
Huh? Oh, all right.
Velvet was jealous. Also, the thing Aizen mentioned, Fujibayashi, is the name of a ninja clan, the one that Suzu and Shina belong to. Suzu's from Tales of Fantasia, and Shina's from Tales of Symphonia.
Can I have my rod back now?
Hey, don't rush me here. If I don't get this squared away now, it'll just cause you trouble later.
I appreciate the effort and all, but do you seriously think we'll actually catch a Therion here?
Beats me, but the first mate hasn't met a fish he can't catch.
Huh. Aizen's really that accomplished of a fisherman?
Hey, Aizen, how about a competition? Let's see who can catch the biggest fish.
Don't be ridiculous. Fishing is a solitary battle. It's about meditation and self-control.
Ooh, aren't you the philosophical one all of a sudden?
But I suppose. I can't deny I really want to put this rod to the test.
Yeah, I know that feeling. Whenever I find a good sword, there's nothing I want to do more than to swing it.
Sure enough. There's just something about good equipment that gets the blood pumping.
Yeah. Although in my case, it's usually more like blood spurting.
A bit too much blood either way, if you ask me.
Listen, we're fishing no matter what. Wouldn't a competition be better for getting that blood of yours pumping?
Fine. You're on. But we both know already how this is gonna end.
You can plan all the victory speeches you like, but fishing is like life. It doesn't always go the way you think it will. You ready? Let's do this.
At what point did the Therion hunt turn into a contest?
If you truly admired the fishies, you'd never dream of doing this to them. No matter how tasty the bait, it's a poor trade for a barbed hook in the lip and a cruel death in the unforgiving air.
I don't admire fish. Fish exist to be caught and eaten, as far as I'm concerned.
Can't argue there. Raw, boiled, or grilled with a little salt. You can't go wrong. And if they're nothing but food to you, even their wretched squirms of agony can hold a kind of beauty.
Old Man Tenny sounds like he was a real goofball.
Definitely. He used to say the weirdest things while we'd be fishing, just to make me laugh.
Like what?
Oh, it was all nonsense, but it was funny to me. The silly stuff like... Papero, papero, pippity-poppity-poo.
Yeah, that's silly, all right.
Those two look like they're having fun.
Hey, Velvet! I've got your rod all set up for you! This thing could even catch a whale if you wanted to. The rest is up to you. Now get out there and fish up a big one.
A Therion, you mean. Might as well give it a shot. It's not like anyone else remembers what we're here for.
Something's pulling the line!
Stay calm. Fishing isn't about strength, it's about timing.
Oh, okay. Got it.
Here it comes. You ready?
Damn right I am. I'll fillet it before it can even land.
If it's a Therion, don't you dare kill it.
Now!
Heave!
Well, what do you know? Neither a fish nor a Therion.
Well, shoot. Can't eat that.
Oh.
It looks like it fit you, though, Lafayette. Why don't you try it on?
I concur. Maybe it'll bring out his unique personality.
My unique personality, huh?
See? What did I tell you? It looks great on you, Lafayette.
You really think so?
Yeah, brings out your special charm, kiddo.
Come on, back to Therion fishing.
Hey, you don't need to take it so seriously.
I have to catch the Therion. Maybe then Velvet will see me for who I am.
Not a bite.
Oh, quit your grumbling. Who was it who said fishing doesn't always go how you think it will?
Spoken like a true, heartless pirate.
Oh, hey! I've got something!
Whoa! Looks like I'm next!
Not a single decent catch.
I think it's decent.
Huh?
You don't take half measures, do you, kid?
Hmm? What's wrong, Lafayette?
You look ridiculous. Take that off.
Stop it! What do you know about me anyway?
I know that looks silly on you.
All you know is you're Lafayette!
Hey, Velvet! Something's pulling on your rod.
Huh? Oh!
It's a big one!
Give it everything you've got!
I know what I'm doing!
It's
a big one, all right, but...
A pot. Yay. But what's a pot doing out here?
There's something inside it.
Ah! An octopod?
I wish they'd stop making those noises.
Watch out! Their arms to the squeeze! And they're shouting, let's hurry to the ring!
Must you? Not even worth my time.
Phew! That was scary.
Be more careful before you approach a suspicious object.
You think Luffy would have stayed back?
That has nothing to do with this!
Hold on. There's something else inside.
What the hell?
Now we gotta fight the shambling dead?
A zombo pot!
For a bunch of dead guys, they're awfully, fleshy.
Further support for the healthy octopus diet.
It looks like no one is injured.
An octopus army? A horde of undead? What the hell is this pot?
Magnificent. To think I'd get to see one with my own eyes.
Huh? Is there something special about this creepy old pot?
Creepy, you say? That's why these things need to be left to the professionals. Listen and behold. This is none other than a water jug made by the potter Grun during King Claudin's reign. It was a legendary once-in-a-millennium masterpiece, but it was lost in the Second Warring States period 200 years ago. Assertive, yet not ostentatious, the piece draws you in with its stately curves and the subtle shimmer of its colors, which belie a hidden savagery.
Two lectures in one day?
Yeah. He's talking gibberish, but that's men in general, I suppose.
The lost glazing technique of the Orosaurin is so vibrant, it looks like it could start moving at any moment.
Huh? Oh, and start moving it did.
Look out! The pot's a demon!
Its weakness is earth.
Whatever you got.
Oh, hey. This changed, I think, right? Didn't change.
Make sure you don't smash it!
So, can I slash it?
That's even worse!
Stop arguing and fight already! Slow down! Crash through! Hit the guy! I'm dead! Pull it down! Crash through! Hit the guy! I'm dead! Throwing black fire, no escape! I'm dead! Running down! Crash through! Shield people!
Bubble! Torture! Windblast!
Armor crusher!
Blast!
No more!
How could I be so weak?
Thank you. Gokuro!
Thanks.
Holy fire!
Was a considerably powerful enemy.
It's finally decided to behave itself.
Wait, Velvet! Don't eat it!
It's a pot. I'm not gonna eat it.
I guess there weren't any Therians to be found here after all.
Yeah, if there'd have been any, you'd think old Aizen's Reaper curse would have drawn him out.
Oh, so that's why all we caught today were weird, useless things.
Right. I forgot about the curse. So all this was Aizen's fault, huh?
Funny how quickly you get used to it.
Oh, my power didn't end up helping us out at all.
Nope. But I know you're not the type to give up after a little setback. Isn't that right, Fee?
Huh? Fee?
It's your nickname. Not a whole lot of thought put into it, but... you're you. You're Fee.
Velvet.
Fee. I like it. It has personality.
Thanks.
Of course, if you still feel like giving up.
No, I'm gonna find us the next Earth Pulse point.
Oh, hey. There's something else inside the pot. This golden luster, it's orichalcum! I get it now. This must be where that ship sank all those years ago. The one Kurogane told us about.
Hell yeah! Kurogane might actually be able to make me an orichalcum sword. Nice find, Aizen. You too, Lafayette.
It wasn't easy, but we didn't come away empty-handed. And just getting a chance to fish again was lots of fun.
Yeah, I had a really good time too.
Even I was entertained. Especially your little costume show, kiddo.
The sun's going down soon. Let's head back to Titania.
It's actually kind of a dumb name. Despite it being Lafayette's new nickname. Oh, what the heck? Didn't that just hit lose? You know, this actually fits a lot more than the hat does. So does the eye patch. Kinda sucks that they limit the equipment to just 3 diamonds. Mustache. Okay. Black bunny ears take up two. Okay, let's see. If I were to remove that. Then it would be up here. Edit the rotation. Okay, let's just make it parallel to her face. So, about there. I kind of want to make it so that the white parts aren't showing. Do it about there, and then I can move this just a little bit. The white parts are showing a little bit, but I think that's okay. I want to make this a little bit gray. Thank you. I just keep it dark like this.
Do they have in common?
What are you up to?
I'm compiling everything we know about Earth Pulse points, starting with what the ones in Ward Forest and Palamedes have in common. I'll compare those points with the ones that didn't have any Therians. Then, I'll factor in everything I currently know about the Abbey's deployments. Once that's done, I'll match all that information against what we know about the locations Lafayette was able to sense. When that's completed, we should be able to tell which locations are more likely to house a Therian.
You're really going all out, aren't you?
Must you sound so incredulous? If you're going to do something, then give it your all. There is no other way to live.
Right. I'm counting on you, then.
I'm not doing this for you. This is for me and for Lafayette. Do you even understand why that boy's trying so hard?
Yeah, I do.
It's because he wants your attention, Velvet.
I spy!
I can't, Kamawana. I've got stuff to...
I spy with my little eye! Something that starts with V!
Okay, I'll try. Is it... Velvet?
No fair! How'd you do it so fast?
Wait, Kamawana, I'm sorry. You don't have to cry.
Poor V.
I still don't like Kamana's voice.
Have you been practicing your dev impression, Velvet?
What? No.
Now. A performer in Mogilu's menagerie has to be more diligent than that. What if we're stopped at a checkpoint and the guards ask you to perform a trick?
If that happens, I'll show them my trick where I devour an entire witch faster than the blink of an eye.
Oh-ho, that would be a sight indeed. But seriously, if you ever want some magic tricks up your sleeve, let me know and I'll teach you some. Just 10,000 gold each.
Check to see if the outside area has more cat spirits, because if you can see, I'm running a little bit low. Respawn. Or, okay, so there's that red icon, so it probably responds with that. No, it isn't.
Hey, Velvet. You don't mind if I give Kurogane that orichalcum you fished up, do you?
Doesn't matter to me. But do you really think he can make a weapon with that?
I don't know. What does the expert think?
Conventionally, no, it's impossible. But when has convention ever stopped a demon?
I won't argue that.
We're dealing with the hardest metal in existence. But I'm ready to cast aside all doubt. To focus everything on forging my greatest creation.
If anybody can do it, it's you. Good luck, Kurogane.
Yeah, best of luck. If you can make Rokuro stronger, you'll be helping me out too.
Mm-hmm. so there's two side quests.
Let me ask you something.
More complaining, is it?
Come on, don't be like that. Every time I turn around, Velvet or one of the pirates is telling me to go make some delivery to some island. I can never get a break.
Isn't that just a sign they think you're a dependable guy?
Maybe, but I don't see them sending you off on errands. It's like they take one look at your face and decide to leave you alone.
I don't have a face.
Oh, right, sorry. Slip of the tongue.
Maybe you just don't know how much work I do around here. It's more than you think. Anything to do with iron, I do it. Making tools, repairing things. What do you take me for? Some kind of cheeky freeloader? I don't even have cheeks.
You're too funny. But doesn't it ever annoy you to have all these kids giving you orders?
I've spent my entire life thinking of nothing but forging swords. It's been centuries since I've interacted with youngsters like them. They can be a hassle, but at least it's a new hassle.
Yeah, that's what I thought at first, so I went along with whatever they asked. But I've been too nice, so they keep pushing work onto me. Maybe if I hadn't been so helpful, they would have stayed out of my face like they stay out of yours.
I don't have a face.
That's not the point. Aren't you even listening to what I'm saying here?
You need to make up your mind. You and I got on this ship alongside these people, who are putting themselves in great danger in order to live the lives of their choosing. If you don't like it, then go on and get off this ship with your tail between your legs.
Yeah, except I don't have a tail right now.
Oh. Oh, hilarious. I was trying so hard not to laugh, just so I wouldn't, like, interrupt the skit. I also thought it was kind of funny that, they had little blush marks on Kurogane.
The oldest known map of the world was made by... Wow, it took them decades!
You always look so happy when you've got your nose in a book. What's so interesting about the one you've got there?
It's a book about surveying. When I read it, I can imagine myself traveling afar and making maps of the world. It sounds like so much fun.
I know just how you feel. I know Mogilu and the others don't understand. But I just can't help but feel excited when I think about us completing a map of the entire world.
It's the thought of treasure that gets me more fired up!
Obviously, there's treasure waiting to be unearthed too, but that's more of a bonus on the side. Crossing uncrossable oceans, going to lands where none have gone before. The voyage itself, the dance with death, these things hold value greater than that of any treasure.
Ah, adventure! Truly the romance of the quest we call life!
Lafayette, you had a map, didn't you? The one you dropped when we first met?
It's a world map I got when I was with the Abbey, but I only checked out the places really close by. I could hardly call it adventure.
There's more to adventuring than visiting far-off lands and sailing stormy seas, you know. Adventures are about achieving your ambitions and leaping across the walls we've built to protect ourselves, no matter the danger that waits on the other side. There are no big or small adventures.
Even if I only went to Helavies and the Figal Ice Caps?
Think of it like this. When you sneaked out of town without the Abbey noticing, when you walked the land and compared it to your map, how did that make you feel?
It was scary, but fun. Exhilarating.
Then it was an adventure. The map you made within yourself is a treasure that's only yours.
Wow! My very own treasure!
Oh, there's another...
Whoa! Awesome!
I swear, the second he has a spare moment, he buries himself in his books.
Knowledge opens up bigger worlds. I imagine that back when Teresa was bossing him around, reading was a fun escape, an adventure in and of itself.
Hmm? What's up, you guys?
You're reading a pretty hard book there, aren't you?
This? It's about dinosaurs. It says that long before humans were around, these huge creatures ruled the world. There are so many different kinds, like tyrannosaurs and triceratops and brachiosaurs. They're all so cool.
They look like dragons to me.
They look similar, but dinosaurs couldn't live inside volcanoes, and they didn't do well in the cold either. But they were crazy huge and strong. Nothing else could even compete with them.
I bet they would have made for great sparring partners. I think this Gigantospinosaurus might be my favorite.
Those two huge points jutting out from both sides of its body make it look just like you and your two swords.
Actually, it's also known as the dual-bladed dragon.
Wow, it really does sound like a perfect match for me then.
Okay, so if they weren't dragons, what were they?
They look a lot like lizards.
Maybe they're like my ancestors or something.
But you used to be a human.
Damn, I think I might have gotten a bit too used to this new body of mine.
I wonder if their tails can fall off too.
Luffy said the last line was just savage. Okay, back to the story. Looks like I can add the mustache. Thank you. 249 to 3191. Black mustache. Now let's get rid of his elf ears. Looks quite dapper. Velcro, I don't think there's anything I can digitally change his style to something that, like, looks somewhat nice. Can have all fumes. Make her look more like. Make her look like an elf, I guess. Some rosy cheeks. Eleanor. Thank you. Okay, that's it for costumes.
Hey, what do you say we track down another Therion?
Sure. From what I can tell, the next closest Earth pulse point is near the center of Midgand.
Midgand, huh? The capital's not far from there. I wonder how things are now that Griffin's gone, though.
Only one way to find out.
Maybe so, but Aizen's not here, you know.
You're right. I haven't seen him in a while. We should probably ask Benwick where he wandered off to.
Yeah.
Hmm? Hold on. There's a letter here. On pretty cutesy stationery, too. Let's just have a quick look-see. As the cold turns bitter and the snow piles up on the mountains, I cannot help but think of you and hope you are in good cheer. As for myself, I am the same as ever, although I recently acquired a rare item that I shall be sending your...
It's rude to read other people's letters, you know.
Yeah, but how else are we supposed to find out whose it is?
Does it say who the sender is?
Uzfamewu Wexov.
Who the hell is that?
Probably someone on this island, if I had to guess.
Hey! Anybody lose a letter?
Do any of these folks look like the type to write a fancy letter?
Point taken.
It could be one of the pirates. Why don't we go to the docks and ask around?
Fine. Just don't forget our mission.
No reply this time either?
Nah, but she's doing okay. I can say that much.
That's good to hear. I can rest easy then.
Now's about getting that pot wrapped. I's got this new sunflower printer. How's that sound?
Hmm. Yeah, that one's cute enough. Let's go with that.
Did he just say cute?
Help you with something?
Someone dropped this letter. Do you have any idea who it might be?
You didn't read it, did you?
Wait, it's yours?
We didn't read it. Much.
You really didn't read it?
No, of course not.
Put this letter in with the package.
Hughes got it! When you ship with the Turtles Express, rest assured your mail is in good hands!
If you're done here, we're ready to head out. Our destination is Midgand.
Yeah, I'm all set.
Was he sending a gift to someone? And with a letter, too.
Gotta be a lady friend, that's for sure.
You think? Either way, that letter was really polite. And did you see that penmanship?
Yeah, I didn't know old Reeps had it in him.
I can hear you two, you know.
Ah!
Yikes! Better watch what we say from now on.
Yeah.
That's funny. It's still about Aizen's sister, though.
I noticed you've come up with your little name for the kid. You sure are the sentimental type, aren't you?
Oh? Calling him Fee doesn't cost me anything, and it's not like I gave it much thought.
That may be the case, but no one else has taken even that token effort. And in doing so, I wonder if maybe you were trying to encourage him to be his own being. After all, one requires a name before he can consider his own identity. Having been given a name, he realizes he is his own entity, separate from others, and a certain formless essence comes to life inside him. And you're the one who set that process in motion for the kid. Whether you intended to or not, you changed him from a puppet into a living being.
So what's your point?
I've been with you since the start of this journey, haven't I? Wouldn't kill you to give me a nickname, would it?
I've never really thought of us as being that close. And besides, you just forced your way into the group.
Come now! I know you've got a bigger heart than that! Surely you have it in you to give a nickname to a dear friend!
We're not dear friends. And even if we were, I'm not good at nicknames anyway.
Please, I'm begging you!
Okay then. Moggy.
Oh, come on, that's so obvious! Can't you put some heart into it for your dear friend?
Fine. Lou.
Do I look like an old man to you? You're not even trying!
Okay then. Witchy Mick Witcherton.
Interesting. Well, if I had to rank it against 1,000 other nicknames, I'd probably put it at number 1,011. A nickname needs to have charm. It needs to leave a lasting impression.
Sure then. Hattie.
Now you're just saying what you see!
Bookskirt.
That's not any better either!
Ms. Creepy Eyes.
That's just an insult! Look, no nicknames based on what you see, and especially no slandering!
Little Miss Witch who smiles around you but stabs you in the back when you're not looking.
Hey, that's personal information!
Look, I told you. I'm not good at coming up with nicknames.
Forget it! I should have known this wouldn't work!
Aizen, what happened to those octopuses?
Dial and Kurogane took them to the kitchen. They said they were going to make dinner for Kamoana.
They're going to feed demons to her?
A Therion needs malevolence to survive.
That's why they carried them off alive.
What do they plan on making?
Octopus ink pasta with takoyaki and fried octopus on the side, and Helvetian octopus carpaccio.
Do they have a takoyaki pan here at the prison?
Kurogane hammered one out with some iron, along with a large pot for the pasta.
Still looking like that? Takoyaki would hit the spot right about now, though.
Octopus ink pasta, huh?
Like squids, octopuses release ink as a defensive mechanism. But theirs is made of different stuff, and is used in other ways. Squid ink is stickier, and acts like a decoy. But octopus ink spreads out like a cloud of smoke. But squid ink has 30 times the savory flavor, so octopus ink isn't used in pasta all that often.
Luffy told me the same thing. He said that's why octopus ink pasta isn't very good.
Luffy said that?
Yeah. So I ended up not making it for him. But I wonder... I guess it doesn't matter, since I can't taste it now.
I'll taste it for you then. So make me some octopus ink pasta sometime, all right?
All right. And I'll be sure to make some that doesn't come from demons.
Hey, who did Aizen send that letter and cooking pot to anyway?
I don't want to think about it. That walloping still stings.
You've got to be curious, though, right?
Maybe.
It was serious stuff. Whoever it is must be important to him. A lover, maybe.
Aizen's lover?
A child wouldn't be happy with that cooking pot, and a man wouldn't want it wrapped up so pretty. A young woman with Aizen's tastes, then. He'd be bound to fall for a miraculous match like that, right?
I don't know. I bet she's that girl with the yellow umbrella.
You really have a thing for her, don't you?
I do not. That's not what I mean.
Then pray tell, what do you mean?
Huh?
Eavesdropping, Eleanor? How unseemingly rude of you. Besides, Luffy said he's free to like whomever he chooses.
You're one to talk about eavesdropping, Moggy Lou. Anyway, it's just that the sunflower design on the wrapping reminded me of her.
Now that you mention it, but does it really matter? He has someone to write to in any case.
True. I can't help but feel a bit envious.
What a nice way of summing it up, Velvet. So you were eavesdropping too, then.
Say, what do you think about Aizen?
Oh, so that's the kind of guy you're into,
Huh. Not what I'd expect, but...
No! I just feel there's something different about him. The way he picks presents, the objects that catch his eye.
Oh, is that all? Boring.
No kidding. All men have some kind of particular interest, big or small.
I suppose that's true, but he seems a bit, shall we say, overly obsessive?
Now that you mention it, he does have a tendency to ramble on about various topics.
And it's not just the items he collects.
There's more to it?
Every weekend, he eats curry for dinner, and every time we go into port, he docks at the third bollard.
Come to think of it, I heard the galley crew complaining that he always needs his pasta cooked exactly the right way.
And when he needs a new outfit, he always goes to the same tailor and returns with identical clothes and boots. It all has to be exactly the same size and in exactly the same color. Turtle says he's very nitpicky.
Sounds like he's not so much picky as he is a pain in the ass.
But I do see a different side of him now. I thought pirates were all rough and filthy, but it seems they can be quite meticulous.
Not much of a reassessment.
It must not feel great only ever getting tails, I bet.
Nah, I don't really mind them much. It's way too late for me to start letting that bother me.
Yeah, but wouldn't it be nice to get heads at least once? Hell, I know I'd like to see that, and I bet Luffy said here does too.
Yeah, I do.
Right? That's why I've brought something a little special. Ta-da!
What's so special about that coin? It looks identical to the one Aizen already has.
The front side does, yes. But both sides of the coin are actually heads. I had Kurogane make it for me custom. If both sides are heads, then not even the Reaper's curse can stop it.
Well, yeah, but that's cheating. What's the point in getting heads if it's rigged that way?
It's not cheating. It's called effort and hard work.
How?
If you always work hard and never give up, you'll make your own way forward. All right, I'm in. I'll get that heads for you.
What?
That crow just flew off with the coin!
Those birds are attracted to shiny objects, I suppose. Damn it! I can't even win against a crow!
Don't sweat it! I figured something like this might happen, so I had a backup ready. Go on, give it a shot. You'll show that curse who's boss this time.
All right, here goes.
I don't believe it! Now Prince Percival's griffin's gone and eaten the other coin right out of the air!
Are you kidding me?
Not to worry. I've got a spare backup. It's time to put that curse on notice.
Right. Here I go.
You gotta be kidding me. Reaper's curse or not, does it really have to go this far over a damn coin?
It's fine, really. I had a feeling it'd turn out like this.
Well, I sure didn't.
Yeah, me neither.
Oh man, these last couple of skits are hilarious. Okay, let's see what that side quest is at the end. The dock.
May I ask you a question?
What?
You're an Earth Moloch, yes? Why live on the sea when your kind sinks in water?
I live on the sea because I'm an Earth Moloch.
I'd be curious to hear more.
Ifrid used to go on about how we should accept what we were born with. But one time he joked about the idea of a pirate who couldn't swim, and he laughed and laughed. I wanted to clobber him right then and there, but it wouldn't have changed the fact that I can't swim. I didn't want some predestined elemental affinity to control who I was. Instead, I underwent tough training to overcome it.
Well, I guess that's one way to approach it. Did this training of yours bear any fruit?
Well, as soon as I stepped into a river, a big flood brought down a landslide from the mountains and swallowed me up. Then, when I tried going into a lake, the seaweed suddenly multiplied and tangled around my body, nearly drowning me. And then, finally, when I tried jumping into the ocean, a huge whirlpool formed with me at its very center.
The Reaper's curse at play?
As far as I'm concerned, my Earth affinity and my Reaper's curse aren't much different, in that they've both shackled me since I came into being. This is about pushing and challenging the constraints I was born with.
So, did you eventually learn how to swim?
Pretty much, yeah. As long as I never let go of my portable life preserver.
Okay, that was also pretty funny. I'm probably gonna upload a bunch of mini skits. So yeah, it's been 1 hour 13 minutes since I started, so I'm just gonna end this here, and I'll continue on in the next part. So if you like this video, be sure to give it a like and subscribe to my channel to stay up to date on content like this when it's released. If you want to play this game for yourself, I'll have in the video description below the Amazon affiliate link for the PS4 version of the game. If you want to play it on PC, it's available in the Steam store. And also linked below, I'll have a group channel that my friends and I manage. It's called Bronze Theory, and we post videos on League of Legends, Overwatch, and other games from time to time, so be sure to check that out. So, until next time, see ya.